Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week we're fishing the East Cape of Baja for Sierra, Roosterfish, Sailfish, and Marlin. And we'll go ahead and do that all in the same morning. Now, if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television.
It's a beautiful fall morning in Baja, and we're fishing out of the Hotel Palmas de Cortez with Nick Kester and John Keizer of Salt Patrol, who just finished up his annual Salt Patrol Billfish Tournament. And now, it's time to do a little fun fishing.
Well, good morning. How are you? Beautiful Baja morning. Gonna go out, do some marlin fishing, a little bit of maybe some Dorado. There's been a lot of Dorado, a lot of marlin right out front here. I'm gonna go out and give it a shot. Tournament was good. A lot of people got marlin, tuna, so, I mean, Dorado, tuna, not so much, but you know, see what happens today.
We've just taken on some good-sized caballito, but we really need to load up on live sardinas as well. Sardinas are great bait for many species, but mainly we need them to help chum up the good-sized bonito, which the sailfish and marlin eat up like candy. We need to run to another bait boat for sardinas, but the time and effort put into getting the bait for the day is well worth it.
So we just ran down from Palmas to La La Vera, which is a little marina right here, and there's a hotel here too. But we're basically picking up bait. They get sardines here, they're netting them here in the morning. So we got our guy, we'll stop, pick up a load of bait, and the small baits we use to chum. And then also you can hook them up live. We were catching stripers on those too. So that was, which is real fun on the real light gear. So see what happens today.
So up top here, looking at the depth sounder on the Lowrance, it pulled up at 83 degrees. Earlier this week, it was at 92 and 83. It's dropping down. It's gonna make these fish come more active and start feeding. We got a great moon, hardly any moon last night, coming off of a full moon. So it should be a go time for sure.
Well, the bite's been in the afternoon lately. It seemed like most of the marlin we've been getting in the afternoon, we were getting doubles. We had several days we had doubles. We were actually, you remember how you take the sinkers and you're waiting, and we were almost like mooching and for them with live bait. And we got doubles doing that. We got doubles trolling live bait, but all of it came like later in the day. So I think now with the moon phase changing a little bit more, maybe the bite will get a little bit earlier morning bite. I'm hoping. We're waiting for our bait delivery here, but in the meantime, we're catching some, a little bit more bait, hopefully. See what we got here. Oh, little rooster.
Little rooster.
Rooster. You got a rooster?
I don't know what I got.
You got something going there.
Doesn't feel too heavy now, but man, he laid into it. Trying to catch bait is what we're trying to catch, and so far we've got a Sierra and a Roosterfish, which hasn't helped out yet. Another Sierra.
Well, we haven't caught any bait yet, but we've caught two Sierra, which not so bad because they're pretty dang good eating. So
another rooster. Even a little one's quite good. Where else can you go while you're waiting for a bait delivery? Catch rooster fishing, see it around.
Waiting for the bait guy to get his bait. Or
I'm watching in the channel there, sitting there watching Sierra jump out of the water. So.
I don't know what it is.
And a Sierra. Yeah, I could be home, you know, there's like 3 inches of rain in Washington right now. And I could sit here, catch bait, you know, be out nice and warm. It's about 85 today. And man, there's no place better to be in winter time. Yeah, that works good. Those big mullet, man, they work good for the big rooster fish right in here.
And then we're kind of going over a little hump out here. We're going to see if we can get some bonita. One more bait, you know, because that was the marlin were really eating those the other day. So we're going to see if we can pick a few of those up. and then we're gonna go fishing.
Get the rest of the bait.
We just put a bonito on board. John's got another one right there. And those are gonna get our big fish for us.
Never have enough bait.
You never know what the marlin are gonna wanna eat each day.
Welcome back to the East Cape of Baja. I'm Justin Wolf. We're on board Ducate with John Keizer and Nick Kester, who are hoping for a morning of fast billfish action. Making sure that you have plenty of bait is key to success, and having a good selection of lures with you can sure help making bait much easier.
So whenever I come down to Baja, I always like to bring some little bit of tackle. One of the things I always include in my tackle box is some Silver Horde Ace-Eye flies. So they make the minis and they make the full-size ones. Nice thing is you can match whatever they're catching. You can cut them down whatever size you want. They have the hard head on them. And also bring some mini squids. And what we noticed this morning, we were catching Sierra on it. Whoop, got bait going there. And we were catching roosterfish on them. So I mean, they're good for all kinds of stuff. They simulate that small bait fish that the fish are feeding on. And so keep them in there, if nothing else, it's gonna help you catch bait, because these guys run out of them, you know. So I always bring a few down, make sure I have them in my box and they're ready to go. They just rig them up whatever size hook they need for that size bait. So load yourself up, away you go. So what you heard back there is basically the bait fish got a little nervous and started taking line out, because it's basically sitting. If you notice, the reel's turning right now. That bait fish, that bonita's out there just swimming around, attracting that, and that fish swimming is attracting the marlin in. So something he didn't like got close to him, and he got nervous and started swimming off. So that's a good sign. So maybe we're gonna get a bite going here in a minute. You don't have to bring tackle down here, but it's a good idea to bring a few things, like we were just talking about, the little squids and ace-eye flies. The other thing you want to have is some good swivels. So these spros, these are power swivels. You notice this is a size one swivel, but it's rated for 330 pounds. I mean, that's what you want, you know. So these are the way to go for down here. You can actually play marlin and stuff on them. And what we'll do a lot of times is we'll come up about this far and tie a swivel in just off the bait, and then we'll run our leader up from there. That gives you that chafing leader. So if this bottom part wears out, you can just retie on the hook, new hook, and set up, and away you go. You don't have to replace your whole leader.
On him.
Sailfish. Yeah,
Nick.
Sailfish?
Yep.
Sailfish. And Nicky is on.
Whoa, we're in the back end.
You notice how we're not pulling everything in?
We're trying to get double. We've had a lot of doubles out here lately, so let's go. We'll get another, maybe we'll get a marlin on the same time. So we're gonna use Nick's fish as an attractor for a little while here. Maybe we'll get another one going. You know, striped marlin and sailfish travel in schools, so you know, likelihood there's way more than one here.
There we go. We'll put a little cushion on the back of the rod. Makes this a little bit easier on me. Not enough to belt up, but it makes it easier on your hip.
Like it.
There, come on. Come on. There he is, out there.
What's nice this time of year, and that's the reason we have our tournament, is all the species of billfish are here. So there's black marlin, blue marlin, stripe, sailfish, and everything is here. So it's a great time to come down here and fish and get out of the rain. Well, tell me the truth, Dick, would you rather be catching blackmouth right now or doing this?
I'd much rather be catching stuff. Sharp noses than blackmouth.
Blackmouth is a winter salmon, so you catch them in the like November on, and they're kind of a delayed release, you know. So we kind of relate cold weather to catching them, and you know, I'd much rather be doing this. This is way more fun.
There we go.
All right, that's a good one. Get up there. Show us this sail. Of all the days, I think I fished, 5 days now? This is the only sailfish I've seen. There been many sails? No, kind of, yeah. Yeah, not too many fishing right now. More marlin. So the captain, he'll back down on him, watch it. Go right after him with the boat. Let's Nick pick up a bunch of line.
Starting to get close.
There's a leader. There's a lot of sailfish typically in this area, but you don't get the big ones. This one's a good sized sailfish. Still a nice fish. Yeah, I mean, he just took off again on him, so. Nice fish.
There we go.
Get my rod to work out, buddy.
Really big one for down here. I don't know, I can't really see it yet, but it's easy 130-ish.
Hey.
Within the first couple of hours, we've made bait and landed our first billfish of the day, a big sailfish. But we can't forget about the great-eating Sierra we caught earlier.
Yeah, I'm gonna have Sierra for dinner. Cut that up. And you can make sashimi out of it, cook it, it's good. The other day, I got a white bonita in the refrigerator. That makes great sashimi. So, I mean, you know, one of the best things about being down here is catch fresh fish, just take it in. They got really great chefs. They can, all over town, different places, and they'll cook it for you, so you can have your catch that day and have it that night for dinner.
Okay, okay, yes, you go. Yes, you go.
Oh, is
it?
Okay, so we got a marlin. And there was another marlin in the pattern, so he's still working out here. So got a bonita over here, I got a sardine out. They'll hit any one of these things, so just a matter of what they want. Then we're going for another.
Nice.
That's tough.
Dude, nice.
Dang, yeah. Luis, I'm impressed, whoa. Dang.
I'm impressed. Oh, yeah. He sounded on me and then he comes straight back up over there. Yeah. Playing a little bit, got one hooked up, trying to get another one to go. There he is. There he is. There he is. Woo! Coming on you, under you, under you. Whopper side. Now, sounding down he goes. There he comes back up. There we go, come on. There he comes, there he comes, there he comes. Coming to the top. Back up. Come on, get up. Get up, out of the water. Up, 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 up.
There he is.
Yeah. Right on. Another one. Right on. One sail, one marlin so far today. And it's not even 9 o'clock yet.
Got a Dorado. Oof. Warm out here. Yeah. Something good to eat here.
So we don't like to get in too big a hurry reeling these in because typically there's at least one more with them. So you can see he's throwing bait, see if he can get, pick up another one.
Eating there.
Welcome back to the Hotel Palmas de Cortez in Southern Baja, which is a fantastic place for a sunrise massage, especially after a few days of intense fishing. It's mid-morning and John Keizer and Nick Kester continue to make fresh bait to entice aggressive striped marlin that tend to swim in schools, making them vulnerable to double hookups.
Yeah, got a little weight behind it. See what happens here. Feels like a marlin. Yep, there it goes. Whew, warm day. I've got my marlin. I'm trolling live bait. And he looks like he's got another one going right here. You got one too, Luis? No? Oh, much better. I didn't even see it. What was it? Oh, there we go. There he goes. There he goes. Oh, double. We got three going?
No,
two?
One out of the way.
Okay. Yeah, working. Double. Woohoo!
Yeah, Nick, pick your line up.
I can't tell.
Okay, I can't tell now either. Mine just got out of town.
Mine's going down.
You're sounding?
Yeah.
Okay, I think I'm way out.
Yeah, you could jump out there. We're doubled up on marlin right now. What we got going on.
So we hooked up one, and then there was another one in the pattern, and Luis hooked the other one. Now we got a double going. Now we're gonna chase them down a little bit.
Right, you keep some gear in the water because these are striped marlin and they school up in schools and you can usually get one to go or two to go. The other day we had one that took two baits in its mouth and we had them on two rods at one time. Tells you how aggressive they are.
There it is. You know, one thing, nice to have down here is a good pair of gloves because you can guide the line on, you know, protects your hands, doesn't slip. So I would include that in my packing list.
Up.
Good fish.
Good fish.
Yeah. All right. Thank you, Luis. All right.
There we go.
Done?
Yeah, come on, bud.
Perfect.
Well, we had a leader. Perfect.
That was good. Woo! Double.
That's double, man.
So we just released a couple marlin and on circle hooks, which my favorite to fish down here. Now we're gonna head in and see if we can get some rooster fish, because we just happen to have some really good rooster fish bait. So we'll see what we get a big rooster. That'll be that's the nice thing about Baja. There's a lot of variety to fish for down here. Got him now. Rooster! Ready? Little rooster. All right, he's out of here.
Oh, God.
Got him?
Yep.
Go. Fun to come to the Salt Patrol tournament, catch roosters like that. There's the dock that we get on the boats at in the morning. This is the beach. We are right in front of the dock.
Hey, thanks for making the time to watch today's episode, and I hope it was time well spent. Now, if we can help you out with your own fishing, be sure to stop into the Angler West store in Woodland, Washington. And remember, without our sponsors, there is no show. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.